Yet another يعني situation is the one after reciting the Quran, he has a dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts, because Anas ibn Malik and other companions, when they finished the Quran, they would call their families and they would make dua to have their families forgiven and increased in their rahmah and mercy. Also, when you're going for Hajj and Umrah and Jihad, all of these situations, any type of good deed that you're doing it, when you make a dua to Allah, this is a situation that Allah responds to your dua. And the last point that we'll mention before moving on to the next topic is the dua for a Muslim in his absence, when he is not in front of you. When you make dua for someone while he is not there, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, there is no Muslim who makes dua for his Muslim brother except that an angel says, and to you be the same as well. So you pray for your Muslim brother, oh Allah, increase his wealth, increase his children, make him guided to Islam, an angel will come and pray and you have the same as well. Look at the beauty of Islam. When you make a dua for your brother, you, an angel is asking that you get the same as well. And the dua of an angel is obviously strongly accepted. The possibilities of it being accepted are more than your own. So when you make a sincere dua for your Muslim brother, know that you are in fact making a dua for yourself. And that is why some of the scholars of the past, when they needed something, they would pray to Allah to bless their brothers with something, with that thing. If they needed good health, they would pray, oh Allah, give so and so good health. Because they knew that the angel would then pray for him to have good health as well. Once one of the companions, Safwan ibn Abdullah, he came to Abu Darda in Syria. And he said, I'm going to go for Hajj. So he said, in that case, do not forget to make dua for us, because I heard the Prophet ﷺ say, the dua of a Muslim in his absence is responded to. And Allah assigns an angel that every time he makes a dua for his brother, the angel says, Ameen, and to you the same as well. So this is an incentive to make dua for our brothers. And how few of us make dua for our brothers. Meaning our brothers in faith, not just our blood brothers, but our brothers in faith as well. How few of us think about our Muslim brothers and sisters? Especially those that are close to us. And by the way, this is a sign of Iman. When you make dua for your friend, oh Allah, increase his wealth. What more sign of brotherhood can that mean? You really want good for him. Oh Allah, guide him. Oh Allah, make him a good Muslim. Look at how this Iman, and indicative of Iman. Imagine a society where everybody is praying for the other person. How will that society be? Will there be any oppression? Will there be any ghibah, any stealing, any backbiting, any slander? How? When you love your brother so much, you're actually praying for him. Imagine the level of Iman that means. Therefore, it only makes sense that when you have reached that level, then your dua is responded to. So if you want something, pray for yourself and pray for your Muslim brothers as well, that Allah grants them that situation as well. And one final thing which is also important, the person who remembers Allah all the time, his dua is always responded to. We mentioned a similar point before. When you show your love of Allah and your devotion to Allah, when you show that you are a pious servant of Allah, constantly reciting Quran, constantly making dhikr, then this is an indication that your dua will be responded to. In one hadith which is slightly weak, the Prophet ﷺ is reported to have said that the one who constantly recites the Quran, constantly remembers Allah, Allah gives him more than the one who makes dua. Because he doesn't have time for dua because of his Quran. He always recites Quran, always remembering Allah, dhikr. The Prophet ﷺ is reported to have said, Allah will give him more than the one who makes dua. Because he was, he didn't make dua because he was engaged in the dhikr of Allah. So he will get more than the one who makes dua. So the one who remembers Allah constantly, his dua is also accepted and responded to by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. With this, move on to another topic. The factors that help a person's dua in being answered, and the factors that prevent dua from being answered. And after we finish with this topic, then we'll take the break for dinner, and then come back for the final talk inshallah, and then question and answer in detail. Many of these factors have been listed before, but for the sake of completeness, we'll mention them again. Firstly, sincerity. The single most factor that ensures dua being accepted is sincerity, ikhlas. When you pray, and you pray with your heart and soul, ikhlas. That is why the dua of the kafir is accepted. That is why the dua of Iblis himself was accepted. Ikhlas. Rabbi anzirni ila yawmi ba'thun. He knew he has no chance except if Allah gives it to him. Therefore Iblis makes a dua to Allah. And if Allah can respond to dua of Iblis, then surely he can respond to our duas as well. Another aspect that increases the chances of dua is to expect the best of Allah. Like we mentioned the hadith before, make dua to Allah when you are certain that Allah will respond to you. And we also mentioned the hadith that the Prophet ﷺ said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that if all of you were to stand in front of me and ask me for everything that you desire, and I were to give them all that they desire, that would still not decrease my dominion, my kingship. Just like when a needle is placed in an ocean, it does not diminish the water of the ocean. So Allah's generosity is so much, His kingdom is so great, that ask and ask Allah expecting for a response from that deed. Yet another aspect that increases the chances of dua is doing good deeds. Doing good deeds. When you increase your good deeds, then this increases your chances of dua being responded to. The Prophet ﷺ said, bring the orphan close to you and be nice to him and wipe his head. This is exactly what the Prophet ﷺ said, wipe his head. Be nice to him, give him food and feed him from your food. If you do so, your heart will become soft and your needs fulfilled. Your dua is responded to. When you are kind to the orphan, when you do any good deed, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will respond to your dua as well. Once Anas ibn Malik, a person came to him and he said, oh Anas, make dua for me. This famous phrase that we all hear, make dua for me. Anas said, verily dua is raised up by good deeds. You want me to make dua for you, I'll tell you something better. Do good deeds and they will act as wings to raise your duas up to Allah. Obviously the more pious a person is, the greater his chances are that the dua will be responded to. Another scholar, Wahb ibn Munabbih, he said, the example of the one who makes dua without doing any good deeds is like the one who tries to shoot arrows but he does not have a bow. If you don't have good deeds, what will lift up the dua to Allah? So when you're making dua, especially when you have something you want to be responded to, increase your good deeds, increase your salah, increase your zakah, increase your charity and your acts of worship. Then know that your chances of dua also go up. Yet another aspect that increases the chances of dua being responded to is fulfilling the rights of the parents. And we learned this from the story of Juraij. And there is another instance as well. And that is the story of Uwais al-Qarni. Uwais al-Qarni, he was a person who was afflicted with leprosy, but his mother made dua for him and Allah was cured, and Allah cured him of that leprosy except for one place of his body, one small mound, if you like, of leprosy was left on his body. So the Prophet ﷺ said, there will come to you Uwais al-Qarni. When he comes, ask him to make dua for you because he is pious to his mother. Because he is pious to his